Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. As an active member of the United Nations, Bangladesh is fully committed to the cause of international peace and security and prepared to work constructively in the promotion of goals as articulated in the United Nations Charter. Such commitment is also outlined in the Constitution of Bangladesh. As Article 25 of its Constitution states that Bangladesh shall base its international relations on the principles of respect for national sovereignty and equality, non-interference in the internal affairs of other countries, peaceful settlement of international disputes, and respect for international law and the principles enunciated in the United Nations Charter. In 1974, Bangladesh became member of the United Nations and since then played an important role in establishing peace across the globe. Only with 17 years of existence as an independent nation, Bangladesh started its contribution to United Nations peace support operation in 1988 by participating in the United Nations Iran-Iraq Military Observer Group. Our peacekeepers had been operating in many of the stressed areas of the world under trying conditions, even to the face of endangering threats. Many of our brave sons of the soil have embraced martyrdom for the noble cause of establishing world peace. Bangladeshi uniformed personnel have set values, norms, and professionalism wherever they were sent. Successive Secretary Generals of the United Nations have admired their role. With this little bit of introduction, the aim of my today's presentation is to give a short appraisal about Bangladesh's peacekeeping mission in the United Nations. In my presentation, I shall try to cover the background history, present state, and key roles of Bangladesh in peacekeeping mission, Bangladesh's glory, benefit, and contribution in the UN peacekeeping missions, factors contributing to become the best nation in peacekeeping. Moreover, before I end, I shall very shortly speak about Bangladesh Institute of Peace Support Operation Training, in short we call BIPSOT. So I shall start with the background of Bangladesh's peacekeeping. Though Bangladesh's participation in the United Nations peacekeeping mission started in 1988 with 15 military observers in the United Nations Iran-Iraq Military Observer Group, the first battalion-sized contingent was sent to United Nations Transitional Assistance Mission in Cambodia in the year 1992. Since then, within less than a decade, Bangladesh became one of the top troops contributing countries of the United Nations to peace missions. Bangladeshi peacekeepers have their peace effort covering large part of the world, especially in the countries of America, Africa, Middle East, and Central Europe. Until today, Bangladeshi peacekeepers took part in 54 peacekeeping missions in 38 countries. The Bangladeshi Armed Forces began its participation in the year 1988, which was followed by Bangladesh Police in 1989. Bangladesh Navy had its first mission in 1992, whereas the Air Force had in 1995. So far, 109,886 Army, 1,527 Navy, 3,987 Air Force, and 12,570 police personnel took part in the United Nations peacekeeping operations. Bangladesh has earned global reputation by sending two all-female police contingents to Haiti and Democratic Republic of Congo. Bangladesh is proud to be the contributor of first female form police unit in the United Nations. Presently, Bangladesh is the world's largest troops contributing country. More than 7,000 peacekeepers from Bangladesh Armed Forces are deployed in United Nations peacekeeping mission across the globe. Among them, 6,100 from Bangladesh Army are deployed in 7 peacekeeping missions. Bangladesh Navy has its ships and watercrafts in Lebanon and Sudan with 396 personnel in 8 missions. The Air Force is also actively involved in peacekeeping missions with 506 personnel and its helicopters and fixed-wing aircrafts in South Sudan, Congo and Ivory Coast. 1,848 members of Bangladesh Police are also deployed in various United Nations peacekeeping missions. Female officers of Bangladesh Armed Forces and Bangladesh Police are participating with an increased number day by day in the peace missions. Bangladesh is the sixth largest contributor of the female peacekeepers. As recognition to the leading role of Bangladesh in peacekeeping, the United Nations recently decided to deploy more 1,310 Bangladesh Army personnel and 130 Air Force personnel in Mali by end of April this year. Bangladesh had remarkable achievement in most of the missions like Cambodia, Mozambique, Sierra Leone, Sudan, and Liberia. Bangladesh has been playing a very important and diversified role in those missions. Bangladesh, as a major troop contributing country, has fundamentally ventured through troop contribution, thus ensuring basic safety and security. In addition, they are also assisting in the security sector reform, disarmament, demobilization and reintegration process. Participation from Bangladesh in core government functions like administration reform, activation of executive and legislative branch, local governance, strengthening national police, justice and correction institution are also very, very significant. Bangladesh peacekeepers took part in the political process of United Nations peace support effort that includes reform in the constitution, electoral process, mediation and conflict resolution, etc. Bangladesh Rural Advancement Committee, the world's largest non-governmental organization, is playing an admirable role in post-conflict peace building in Afghanistan, Liberia, Uganda, Sudan, and Sierra Leone. Bangladesh Army engineers are contributing in the construction and repair of infrastructure in the mission areas through various United Nations projects. Since 1993, Bangladesh provided efficient leaders for the United Nations peacekeeping operations. Bangladesh Armed Forces provided force commander for the United Nations Observer Mission in Georgia, United Nations Mission in Mozambique, Sudan, Liberia, Ivory Coast, and Western Sahara. Former Special Representative of the Secretary General in East Timor, Mrs. Amira Hawk of Bangladesh, has been appointed as the Under Secretary General of the Department of Field Support. The Bangladesh Permanent Mission in the United Nations has also effectively contributed in increasing wages and the death and disability compensation of the peacekeepers. The foregoing achievements have not come without sacrifices. Bangladesh peacekeepers have never retreated in the face of danger, confronted with unknown enemies on the foreign soil. Peacekeepers working under complex and dangerous circumstances have risk of death and injury. Moreover, there are illness and accident. So far, 109 peacekeepers have sacrificed their lives and 165 more sustained injuries in the call of duty. The supreme sacrifice of Bangladeshi peacekeepers has placed the country to a respectable position in the globe. Bangladesh's contribution to the United Nations peacekeeping prompted former United Nations Secretary General Mr. Kofi Annan to describe it, I quote, a model member of the United Nations, providing leadership among the least developed countries and contributing substantially to the peacekeeping of humanitarian operations, I unquote. During a visit by present UN Secretary General His Excellency Mr. Ban Ki-moon to South Sudan, he applauded Bangladeshi peacekeepers and said, my deep admiration and commendation for all the noble work Bangladeshi contingent has been making for the peace of Sudan. As recognition to Bangladeshi peacekeepers' contribution and testimony of love and respect, President Alhaj Ahmad Tezan Kaba declared Bangla as the official language in Sierra Leone in 12 December 2002 and paid a visit to Bangladesh in October 2003. During the United Nations General Assembly session of 2010, the Secretary General Ban Ki-moon and President of the United States, Mr. Barack Obama, both conveyed their appreciation for Bangladeshi peacekeeping forces. In addition to the economic benefits, Bangladesh peacekeeping are also fetching the following. The peacekeeping efforts have made Bangladesh Army more proficient in performing their classical tasks, which normally they perform in their home under innate to civil power. Participating in the United Nations mission with active support of the development partners enhances Bangladesh's profile in the regional and global forums, thus increase the country's influence in the international and multilateral settings. Allow Bangladesh to develop relations with the conflict-afflicted region and countries. Bangladesh peacekeepers have also gained professionally from the global exposure as they are introduced to different systems of military management and equipments, types of conflict management, etc. Bangladeshi forces are getting chance to work under conditions which are continuously evolving, complex and multidimensional, thus improving their tactics of warfare and combat experience. Bangladesh joined quite late in the United Nations peacekeeping missions but has accelerated quite fast. The constitutional obligation, sincerity of the government and appropriate foreign and defense policy are the main reasons for such acceleration. The foreign policy has a strong motivation to the cause of global peace. It directs peacekeepers to maintain a high diplomatic and strategic profile in the global peace architecture under United Nations umbrella. It also directs to build a peace leadership portfolio at the United Nations and at conflict zones. Propagate national values globally, feel noble as a nation serving humanity. And finally, enhance image, reputation, skill of its armed forces at hostile and humanitarian crisis. Bangladesh Armed Forces have vast experience in the nation building and disaster management activities, which help them to provide support to the nation building process of the conflict-torn countries. Bangladesh Armed Forces was involved with the counterinsurgency operation for more than 20 years, which has enhanced their ability to adapt to the local requirements. The experience of conducting counterinsurgency operation has also molded Bangladesh Armed Forces to have more caring attitude towards the local people of the countries which they are operating. In most missions, Bangladesh uniformed personnel went out of their way to help the local peoples. Bangladeshi peacekeepers are highly motivated, committed, and they are not involved in gainful transactions and internal affairs of the host countries. Importantly, prior to their deployment, Bangladesh Armed Forces are being trained in BIPSOR. In 2002, Bangladesh established BIPSOR, a prestigious institute dedicated to training of peacekeepers for employment in all types of United Nations peace support operations. This institute fulfills the requirement of United Nations as General Assembly Resolution, which outlines the necessity and respectability of the every nation to train their armed forces before any deployment. The mission of this institute is to impart specialized training to potential peacekeepers on the United Nations peace support operations. BIPSOR is providing tactical and operational level peace support training to potential peacekeepers and developing faculty to carry out research on peace and conflict studies. Since inception, BIPSHOT is directly or indirectly contributing in the training of all 10 peacekeepers of the world. It is a privilege for conducting the largest field training exercise on the peacekeeping operation in 2012, co-sponsored by United States Pacific Command. To conclude, I would like to say modern day peacekeeping is a complex business demanding firm commitment, research support, and in many cases, confrontation with the belligerents under Chapter 7 in the pursuing the mission's mandate. As such, preparing troops have been a demanding task for the troops contributing countries. The issue has been further compounded owing to the shrinking peacekeeping budget. However, ever since Bangladesh was invited to participate in the United Nations peacekeeping operation in 1988, it did not look back in fulfilling its constitutional obligation to global peace and security. Bangladesh had been making its voice heard both in the diplomatic front and in the troop contribution. Thank you very much.